People always ask me, what is PR? Most girls think the life of a PR girl is all about parties, fashion, and social media. I'm Allie Maresco, and I'm going to show you the grit and grind behind what it really takes to be a PR girl. Victoria Kent is a total badass. She is the founder of Victoria Kent PR here in Chicago. She's like been someone that I've like admired for a while now. So I cold emailed her and asked her if she would consider being on our Movers and Shakers panel. And thankfully she agreed to grab lunch.
I'm happy I got to finally like sit down with you because I've been stalking you on Insta stories for like so long. Obviously like you're a strong female entrepreneur and I'm putting on this like PR and journalism centered panel in July.
Cool.
And I just want a really great group of badass women from like all different areas of PR to like kind of come together and answer questions and like truthfully like provide knowledge to our attendees. And I want it to be stories like we haven't heard anymore. Yeah. I'm so sick of seeing the same names in like Chicago
media.
Me too. So you were like one of the first people that popped into my head. So I
want to
see if you
would
like consider doing it because I know you're so busy.
Yeah, I would love to. Kind of one of my New Year's resolutions is to like do more public speaking and promoting my own brand, which is like not
it's
my
It's hard
thing.
To do as a publicist.
It is. I'd rather give that to one of my clients.
Yeah.
And it's so much easier to be like stage mommy in the back and be like, smile,
that's a good
do
way
this.
To put it,
right? That's me. I'm stage mom. Stage mom and professional babysitter.
Well, cheers to your New Year's resolution. I'm excited to have you on our panel.
Yeah, this is so exciting. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Hey, what's up? This is my place, and I want to show you everything. He was a stray. His name was Trouble, and my girlfriend picked him up, renamed him Pickles. He peed on TV. Yeah, you were on the Windy City Live, and you took a big pee-pee. My girlfriend's piano. I don't play the piano. I can do it. The Ray Charles, Stevie Wonder. Espresso machine, that's very important when you're waking up at 4 o'clock for a 5 o'clock flight. Everything in my office has its place. Although it may seem a little bit like a tornado came in here, everything is exactly where it should be. This is the life I've chosen. This is my typical schedule, being on the road 190 days a year. This art was made by the Sharpie King. He's a local Chicago artist. Pretty darn cool. And I just happen to have these two first place trophies. Karate? Nope, Taekwondo. Yep, that was for form and this was for competition. They belong to my girlfriend. I don't do sports. I'm a lover, I'm not a fighter. That's my house.
I'm so pumped. Mindy is finally back from her 23-day honeymoon. And it's the first time she's gonna meet my other two good friends, Sam and Mary. So everyone will kind of just be coming together for the first time. And I know Sarah has some tricky things up her sleeve for the bachelorette party, so we're kind of gonna get filled in on that.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
Okay, wait. So this is Mindy, who I know you guys have been like, she hasn't been here.
The
Mary,
Mindy.
Sam.
Yeah, I know, hi, the Mindy. Nice to meet you.
She was
you.
On her month-long honeymoon.
Oh my gosh.
And that's why she couldn't be here with us.
I know.
Guys.
It was felt like forever.
Yeah. Thank you.
I'm so sorry I'm late, though. Did I miss anything?
Yeah. No. I've been waiting my whole life for
this. But don't get cocky, girl.
All right. Thursday night, we're going to Bar Cocina, drink some sangria, eat some guacamole, mostly drink sangria. Friday, we're going to brunch. Thank God for brunch. Friday night, we're doing a barbecue and drinking games. Saturday during the day, we're doing a surprise little getaway for Alex to the West Loop. And then this first Saturday night, I booked axe throwing for all of us. Lose a limb for a marriage.
We're gonna take an axe and we're gonna throw it at a target.
After axe throwing, we're going to Three Dots and a Dash and other places if needed. I'm assuming everyone will be gone after Three Dots. And then Sunday, we're getting brunch at Alex's Kitchen. God bless you.
I love Sarah, but she is crazy when it comes to planning my bachelorette weekend. I'm so excited, but right now, you know, there's no time to even think about it. Chris just told me he's going to Japan to film a special, and I have to get him ready to go.
Sorry, Pickles. Chris?
Who's that? You know her. Come on. That's the manager. Pickles!
Well, baby, I'm so sorry.
You keep me safe.
Please don't pee anywhere today.
Only on TV. Hey.
Only on TV. Perfect.
Thanks for coming over.
How are you feeling?
Good. Early flight, but I'm almost unpacking.
Okay, is that how you're gonna pack all of your stuff?
This is how I always pack all my stuff.
Okay.
You haven't seen this before?
No, I haven't actually.
I've thought about this. I take all my clothing from the hamper that I just worn, I put in my suitcase, and then when I get there, I wash it so it's really fresh.
You're literally sure there's somewhere to wash it in Japan?
Yeah, it's Japan.
Okay, I'm just making sure.
It's a big country.
I've never been to Japan, Chris.
I haven't either. I'm excited.
Okay, so, I mean, this is a very quick turnaround. You literally just told me you were going.
In Japanese, milk is milk. Remember that.
That's good. But, like, what kind of milk? That's the question I'm
asking. Soya! Ha ha!
Like, what kind of milk are they giving you? Okay, but you feel good. You feel,
I feel
ready.
Great. I got my camera.
Okay.
I just
you're
got
gonna film.
This. I'm filming right now.
You're gonna film while you're there.
Yep.
Okay.
I got my translator.
And okay, so he speaks.
He speaks Japanese and English.
Okay, and so he can kind of get you around then.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, while you're gone, I told the guys in New York if they need anything, please email, call me anytime.
Okay. Cool.
Just in case, because I don't know obviously what service will be like out there. And I mean, like, you're in Japan. Don't be on your phone the whole time or, like, your computer.
Yeah. As little as I check emails now, it's going to be, like, so much worse.
Well, as long as you have everything and you feel good, I feel good.
Do you want anything from Japan? Sushi?
Please don't bring me raw fish home.
It's a rarity lately that I actually make it out to a lot of these late night work events just because I'm so tired by the end of the day. But today I'm pulling up my bootstraps and I'm going to a big bulk event at Chicago Illuminating Company, which is the same space that I'm hosting my Sublime Soiree at. Boca Group is like the premier restaurant group here in Chicago. They are being generous enough to give us two chefs for a Sublime Soiree.
So we're here tonight at the Boca Group event at Chicago Illuminating Company to kind of just get some design ideas, see what we need for our Sublime Soiree in August.
This is going to be the best charity event all year.
I've reached a point in my life where I definitely realize it's my decision what kind of people I surround myself with and what kind of friends I choose. Thank God all of my friends are positive, encouraging women.